Christianity and the rest of man's religions offer up to our Creator a win-lose proposal. The fantasy offer that you lift up to Him is that you win eternal life, but He loses. He loses because He has to put up with your rebellious, uncircumcised, tell Him how it is nature for eternity. He has bad news for you. Entry into His eternal family does not work this way. His proposal to us is win-win or no deal. We either choose to become as He is, or He sentences us to the death penalty. This is a reality that the testimony of His word testifies to. Sin is transgressing against His word. His word testifies to His righteous character. Therefore, sin is transgressing against His righteous character. Instead of loving who He is, those of you who are in the scattered nations of Israel, who are in the blasphemous religion of Christianity, desire and love make-believe images of His character. In order to be forgiven and atoned for, you must turn from your rebellion to His word. You must turn from your rebellion to His righteous character that His word testifies to. Our Messiah spoke this when He told us that we must repent and be baptized. Turning from our rebellion to the Most High and His righteousness is what repentance is. When we do, then He turns the water that we are baptized under into His Son's shed blood and we are cleansed. If you have been baptized without turning from your rebellion to Him, you merely got dunked in some water. And water by itself does not atone for anything. During this era of time that we have now come to the end of, Yahweh has allowed for us to go our way and to depart from Him. When our ancestors departed from walking with Him on His path, He simply put blinders on their eyes so that they could not see Him, and He stopped their ears from hearing His voice, and He sent them into the captivity of believing into lies. For Israel's descendants, this captivity is Mystery Babylon. It is the false belief that is found in the blasphemous religion of Christianity that tramples His righteousness under your feet. Babylon represents the captivity. You trample His Son's shed blood under your feet by using it for license to transgress against the Most High. Here is what He tells us about why He sent our ancestors and their children into the captivity in Ezekiel 20. Because you did not do My judgments, and you despised My statutes, and you profaned My Sabbaths, and your eyes were on following after your father's idolatries. So I gave you over to statutes and to judgments that were not good, and that would not save your lives. And here is what He tells us about how long this captivity would exist in Isaiah chapter 6. And He said, go and tell this people that hearing they will hear, but they will not understand, and seeing they will see, but they will not know. The hearts of this people will wax fat, and I will cause their ears to be heavy, and I will shut their eyes, lest they see with their eyes and hear with their ears and understand with their hearts and turn back and be healed. Then I said, Adonai, how long will this be? And He answered, until the cities are wasted without inhabitant, and the houses without man, and the land is desolated to devastation. What part of this don't you understand? Our Messiah was sent to our ancestors speaking in parables for a reason. He told His disciples that in order to receive His Father's seven spirits that give us eyes to see and ears to hear, that we must obey His commandments. Yeshua told us that we must walk as He walked. He told us that unless we were guarding and holding fast to that which was given to us, that He would come like a thief in the night to harvest His Father's first fruits, and that we would not know when He came. In Matthew chapter 13, and the disciples came and asked Him, why is it that you speak to them in parables? And He answered them and said to them, because it is given to you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but it is not given to them. It was given to His disciples because they were following Him. They were walking with Him as He walked. Are you doing so? If not, then eyes to see and ears to hear the Most High are not given to you. In verse 12, it is given to those who hold Yahweh's word, and they will abound. But those who do not hold His word, that which they hold will be taken from them. Therefore I speak to them in parables, because seeing they do not see, and hearing they do not hear, neither do they understand. And in them the prophecy of Isaiah is fulfilled, which says, hearing they will hear, and they will not understand, and seeing they will see, and they will not know. Holding His word is possessing it in our hearts. Holding His word is laying siege to that which His word testifies to. It is holding the Most High's righteous character that His word testifies to. It is holding Him. If you are not holding His true image with all of your heart and with your entire mind and with your entire life, you are not holding Him. And the image of Him that you hold is going to be taken from you. It is because you do not hold to His word and His true image that His word testifies to you that He has cut off your eyes and your ears, and you do not know and you do not understand. This is why you do not know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven. He has closed your eyes and stopped your ears from seeing and hearing him, and he has given you over to believe into lies that will not give you eternal life. Verse 15, because this people's hearts are waxed fat and their ears are heavy of hearing and their eyes are closed, lest they would see with their eyes and hear with their ears and understand with their heart, and they would turn back and be healed. But blessed are your eyes because they do see, and your ears because they do hear. Being cut off from the Most High is the captivity, and this captivity flowed into the captivity of Mystery Babylon. He gathered the scattered descendants of Israel into what became the English-speaking countries and gave them over to believe into the lies of Christianity. He cut our ancestors and us off from him, but he also called us out from the captivity to return to him. He did so through the testimony of his word. And from our midst, those who came to his call became his first fruits. They overcame by the testimony of his word, through the testimony of his word. If you do not live by every word that proceeded forth from the Most High's mouth like we are commanded to, why do you think that he has given you eyes to see and ears to hear? If he has, then his word is a lie. And I can guarantee you that his word is not a lie. It is those of you who say that you have his spirit, apart from living by every word that came out from his mouth, that are the liars. Yeshua told us that many were called, but only few are chosen. Why don't you believe him? There is a reason why few are chosen. It is because few came to the Most High's call. He made his word available to us in order to call us out from the captivity to return to him. He allowed for the abomination of desolation, Saul of Tarsus, to stand in his word as part of testing and proving us. He gave his holy or set apart word to those who were to be holy or set apart to him in order to set us apart to him to become as he is. But you have denied the testimony of his word. You claim that you believe his word, but your actions in your flesh deny it. Even his creation testifies to his righteousness. He created that which opposes his righteousness in order to give us a choice. One person recently told me that it sounds like he created this to fail. No, he created this to overcome. And he told us that we can only overcome one way, and this is through the testimony of his word. We have to walk with him in his word in order for him to walk with us to teach us to become as he is. He does not walk with us on a path that is not his path. He did not create us to make him in the image of that our hearts desire. He created us to walk with him to become as he is. His word says so. And through the testimony of his word, then we can have his son's shed blood applied on our behalf to atone for us. He chose the descendants of Israel, but we have to also choose him. Choosing him is choosing his true righteous character. In order for there to be a choice, he had to give us the opportunity to choose that which opposes him. Therefore, he had to give us the opportunity to fail. He is building his eternal life from those who choose to become as he is. Like I've said in other videos, this life here in the flesh is a testing and proving ground. Our life here in the flesh is serious business, but you don't take it seriously. Instead, you take it for granted, and you take his son's shed blood for granted. It is a defeatist attitude to roll over and to not seize the opportunity to become his eternal children. Yeshua said in Matthew 11, moreover, from the days of John the Baptist, including now, the kingdom of heaven is seized, and the forceful or the determined lay hold of it or seize it. The reality is we have to seize his offer to become his eternal seed. We have to seize his righteousness. He does not owe us eternal life, yet he offers it to us, and his offer is very fair. What is unfair is your win-lose offer that you offer up to him. It is unfair to him. His offer to us is win-win. Your win-lose offer is actually a lose-lose offer because both you and the Most High lose. Your choice to remain in the captivity causes you to lose out on eternal life, thus it causes him to lose a child. His word tells you to come out from Mystery Babylon and to return to him, but first you have to realize that you are in the captivity. And for this, you must measure what you believe to be true with his word. In Isaiah 28, in that day, Yahweh's host will be a crown of glory and a diadem of beauty to the remnant of his people. And he will set at the gate in judgment to judge with his spirit and also the strength of battle to turn back those who have erred through wine and gone astray through strong drink. Both the priest and the prophet have erred through strong drink, and they are swallowed up from wine and they have gone astray through strong drink. They err in vision and they stumble in judgment. In the following verses in chapter 29, Isaiah recorded that you are drunken, but not with wine, and you are gone astray, but not with strong drink. He tells us that your drunkenness and your going astray resulted from closing your eyes. Because all of your tables are full of vomit and dung, and your place is without, you are shut off from the Most High. Who will he teach knowledge? Who will he give understanding of his word to? To those who are weaned from milk and drawn from the breast. Because precept upon precept, precept upon precept, measuring line upon measuring line, measuring line upon measuring line, here a little, an insufficient amount here, and there a little, an insufficient amount there. Because with mocking lips and a different tongue, a different way of speaking, he will speak to this people through his servant, and he will say through his servant, this is that which will give rest to the weary and give them comfort, and this is the place to escape the toil. Yet they will not be willing to hear you. You will not hearken, he says. He is telling you that it is time for you to be weaned from the wine of fornication that you have erred in, that you're drunken on. It is time for you to be drawn from the bottle of the strong drink that you have gone astray with. He is telling you that he will remove the blinders and give you eyes to see and ears to hear if you will put aside the captivity and return to him. Yahweh's word exists to you precept upon precept, precept upon precept, measuring line upon measuring line, measuring line upon measuring line, here a little and there a little, in order that you could walk and stumble backwards and be broken and snared and be taken captive. He gave us his word in this manner so that we could go astray. And again, he is building his eternal family from those who conquer and overcome and lay siege to his righteousness and his kingdom. The rest are sent into the captivity. He gave us his word in this manner to test and prove our resolve to become his children. If you loved his true enemies that his word testifies to, you would have embraced the testimony of his word, and he would have not closed your eyes and stopped your ears. He would not have cut you off from seeing him and hearing him. Verse 14, stand upright and hear Yahweh's word, you babblers, you Babylonians, that rule this people which are Jerusalem, referring to his set apart people. You have made a covenant with death, and you are in agreement with the grave, because you have made lies to be your refuge, and you have hidden under that which is false. You say, because the overflowing scourge will pass, and it will not come upon us. You have hidden behind lies that have caused you to believe that his wrath will not come upon you. You need to face the facts that his word testifies to. You have made the lies that came out from Saul of Tarsus' mouth your refuge. The covenant with death that you have made is your false salvation doctrines that you have embraced. The reality that you need to face is either Saul lied or the eyewitnesses to our Messiah's walk here in the flesh, Matthew and John, lied. Either Saul lied or the Most High's prophets lied. The problem for you is, if you want to believe Saul over the prophets, our Messiah testified to the writings of the prophets, and he prophesied against Saul. He told us that another would come in his own name and that you would listen to him instead. And why did you choose to listen to him? It is because the Most High gave you over to listen to him. And why did he give you over to listen to him? It is because you failed in the testing and proving of his word. Most of you failed to even show up for a single class. It is because you did not seek Yahweh's righteousness in his kingdom. You desired your own brand of righteousness, and you desired your own fantasy kingdom. Folks, this really is this simple. It is merely a matter of believing our Creator's word and letting it testify to what is true. I'm going to break this off here and do a part 2.